There are people out there designing and building gajillion-dollar buildings every day here. And I get to help this place be phenomenal so that they can build their buildings. How could I not love that? I mean, I don't know. It's just me. It's in me, you know? And I think, but that's me everywhere. You know, in theater, I'm that person too. I'm like the den mom. I'm the one that people go to and say, oh, what time are we starting and what are we doing? And so it carries through in every aspect of my life, you know, at work, at home. I mean, I'm the planner. I'm the social coordinator, you know? So I think that it's just me. And I think DPR, they do this a lot. They just find the right person. I was the right person. I was the one who people would feel comfortable to come to ask even the silliest questions. Like, do they put mayo on my sandwich? Oh my God. To, oh my God, I'm gonna have 60 people here and I need to throw an event in an hour. Can you do that for me? To ask me how I do it every day, I don't know how I do it every day. I think I'm meant to do it every day. My mom knew at a very young age that I like to be in front of groups of people. So she fostered that. She put me in choir. And then from there, I got an interest in theater on my own just by exposing myself to just going to see shows. And then from that, I fell in love and I, you know, never kind of looked back. I'm constantly got my hands on something, whether I'm performing in something or trying to direct something or producing or I'm actually trying to produce a play right now that was written for my friend. You know, so it's something that I'll never give up. It's really who I am at my core. I just ignore it, but they keep saying we laugh just a little too loud. We stand just a little too close. We stand just a little too long.